Welcome back to the Sawyer Center, ladies and gentlemen. Second half of our doubleheader coming up right now. The SNU men looking to knock off Arkansas-Monticello this afternoon and snap a two-game losing streak and get back to their winning ways. SNU has clinched a spot in the Great American Conference Championships coming up in 2 weeks out in Shawnee at Fire Lake Arena. We will be there for the duration of that tournament as long as SNU stays alive here on Crossover Radio Sports, and look forward to being out there once again with everyone. But SNU coming into today off a 71-68 loss to Southern Arkansas on Thursday night. A tight contest. SNU shot 54% for the game, Southern Arkansas 51%. But SNU just couldn't get the shots down the stretch, and Ty Archibald a couple key buckets late for Southern Arkansas to give the Mule Riders the win over the Crimson Storm. Tough one to swallow for sure. Meanwhile, the Weevils coming into today's game having lost three in a row, five of their last six. They're 10-14, 6-12 overall on the outside looking in for the Great American Conference Championships as things stand today. But they lost a buzzer beater to Oklahoma Baptist on Thursday night as Harrison Stoddart's corner three with a second remaining gave the Bison the win over Monticello. So two teams dealing with the emotions of tough losses this afternoon. We'll see which one responds better here today. SNU without Jalen Lynn today as he's in street clothes, still dealing with that injury. But a couple days off upcoming for the Crimson Storm with no Monday game next week. Starting lineups being introduced for both squads. Let's run through those for you. First up for the Weevils under first-year head coach Chad Tapp. Number one, junior guard Ray Price, 6'3", from Bartlett, Tennessee. The Lyon College transfer, averaging 10.5 points, 3 rebounds per game this season. Number two, senior guard Richard Fagan, 6'1", from Detroit, Michigan, 12.7 points and 3.6 rebounds per game this season. Number 20, junior guard Jesse White, 6'7", from Houston, 3 points, 2 rebounds per game this season for White. Number 23, freshman guard Wesley Booker, 6'4", from Mount Vernon, Arkansas, 7.7 rebounds per game this season for Booker. And number 24, sophomore forward Cole Anderson, 6'8", from Magnet Cove, Arkansas, 7.8 points and 2.5 boards per game this season. Again, Chad Tapp in his first season at the helm of the Weevils, coming over from Lyon College, an NAIA school, this past offseason. For the Crimson Storm, the starting lineups. Number zero, junior guard Adokie Eia, the 6'3 guard, averaging 14.5 points per game this season and 3 rebounds as well. Number three, junior guard Xavier Bryant, 6 foot, from Dallas, 8.5 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists this season for Bryant. He also has 43 steals to his credit this year. Number five, redshirt junior guard Manny Dixon, 6'5", from Trenton, New Jersey, 8.8 points per game, 4.5 rebounds per game for Manny. Number 13, freshman guard Tyler McGuy, 6'5", from Denton, averaging 17 points per game. Back-to-back 20-point performances for McGuy. And in the middle, number 21, sophomore forward Nick Davis, 6'9", from Arlington, averaging 9.5 points and 5 rebounds per game this season. Also has 24 blocks to his credit this season as he has grown as a rim protector this season. Good crowd on hand for this one at the Sawyer Center. Just one more home game to go after today. Next Saturday against Southwestern. And we will have it for you here on the SNU Athletics YouTube channel. But in the meantime, it's the Weevils and the Crimson Storm. Weevils in their road, black Weevils in green across the front with white trim. SNU, their home whites. Southern Nazarene in crimson across the front with crimson numbers. Should be a good one today as Anderson and Davis tip it up. Anderson controls the tip for the Weevils, and the Weevils will move left to right. Booker has it. Now left side, Jesse White. McGuy with the assignment there. Now Price. They swing it around the perimeter. It ends up in Fagan's hands. Fagan will drive. Pulls up from the left elbow. Lost the basketball. Was knocked out of bounds by SNU with six on the shot clock. So Monticello will trigger it in on the right side. Down from us. Fagan has it. Four. Fagan, inside out dribble. Cut off. Has to get a shot away. And they're not going to. That's a shot clock violation for the Weevils. So great start defensively here for SNU, forcing the turnover. It's a shame the Weevils didn't bring their mascot with them. One of the more interesting characters you will see in college athletics.
Every time I see that thing when we travel to Monticello, I immediately have to crack up just a bit.
It's just so goofy looking. If you're not familiar, a boll weevil is a insect that eats cotton and destroys cotton plants, which is interesting that the female Monticello teams are the cotton blossoms, as that's what the weevils feed on. So interesting back and forth there. Foul on Cole Anderson inside on the entry pass to Nick Davis. Be his first personal foul. Minute gone by in the opening half. Bryant lobs it into Davis. He'll spin inside. Working on Anderson. Got deep on him and rolls in the layup. Nick Davis, conference leader in field goal percentage, shooting over 71% from the field this season. It'd be a top five number nationally if he had enough field goal attempts to qualify. Price on the left wing. Over to White. Now back to Booker. SNU in a man-to-man defense here. The Weevils very deliberate. We heard from Adam Bohunch in the pregame. Left-hand hook from Anderson in the middle of the paint is short. And EIA, the rebound, long lead pass, looking for Dixon, but Fagan dashes in front to knock that away out of bounds. So it'll stay with the Crimson Storm as McGuy will inbound in front of Monticello coach Chad Tapp. Bryant to McGuy, SNU weaves, and Dixon gives it up to Davis, top of the key. EIA. Top of the key, steps inside, pulls up from the foul circle. It's short. Booker the rebound. Booker had 13 rebounds in the first matchup between these two teams down in Monticello back on January 20th. Fagan, entry pass to Anderson. Outside to Price. Pulls the trigger for three. It's long. Anderson controls the carom, though, and a fresh 20 for Monticello. Work it back around the perimeter. Ends up in White's hands. Back to Fagan. Now Price to Booker on the curl, and Davis rejects it off the backboard. Another block for Nick Davis. Has really done a nice job on that part of his game of late. McGuy to the elbow. He'll bring it back out and give it over to Bryant. Set a screen for him. Bryant gives it to Davis, and Davis penetrating. Pivoting. Now gives it out to McGuy with eight on the clock. McGuy pulls up from three from the right wing. That one's an air ball. And here comes Price.
You can hear the SNU bench calling out that 10 count because the shot clock is a little small off to the left on the Storm side of the offensive end.
Yeah, clock and shot clock on the left goal to our left. Not functioning today. So the shot clock in the stands. Visible for the most part. A couple blind spots. White dumps it into Anderson. Five on the clock. Anderson pump fakes. Pivots. Forces it up with the left hand. It's no good. And EIA the rebound. 3.5 minutes gone by first half. Still 2-0. SNU with the lead. EIA cutoff. Gives it to Dixon. EIA in the corner to McGuy. Up top to Bryant. Bryant dumps it down low to Davis. Davis pounding in the paint, gallops around Anderson and lays it in for two. 4-0 SNU, 4 minutes gone by. Weevils 0 for 4 with a turnover. SNU now 2-for-4. Anderson inside. Finds the cutting Price cut off. Booker steps back. Three-pointer is no good. Davis has it swatted out of his hands by Anderson. That'll take us to our first media timeout. 15:46 to go in the opening half. Southern Nazarene pitching a shutout now, 4-0 over the Weevils of Monticello. We'll be back with more after these messages. This is SNU Basketball. Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. Southern Nazarene with a 4-0 lead here in the early going over Arkansas-Monticello. Couple of subs both ways. Jabari Sweet in for the Weevils, and Ian Mowat, the freshman from Austin, Texas, in for SNU as Adokie EIA taking a quick breather. McGuy drives all the way in. Finger roll layup off the glass is good from the freshman from Denton. 6-0. To the Crimson Storm here in the early going. SNU got off to a great start in Monticello as well, led by 18 at halftime, 32-14. Shot just 33% in the second half. Got down to 6 with a minute and a half to go. Fagan, right wing three, is online and good. And Richard Fagan breaks the scoring drought for Monticello 5 minutes in. 6-3 Storm. McGuy between the circles, now over to Bryant left wing. Now McGuy has it. Open three. On the way, and he answers. Tyler McGuy, 26 on Monday against Oklahoma Baptist, 25 on Thursday against Southern Arkansas. Having himself a week. He's got 5 here. SNU leads 9-3. Fate White was bumped into by Price as he went low to get the basketball. And Price kicked it out of his hands out of bounds.
Listen, you a little short-handed this afternoon with Lynn out. Manny Dixon got the start.
We've talked a lot about Manny up and down throughout the season. A little bit in production, but just as far as his role, kind of yo-yoing between starter and coming off the bench.
And nonetheless, he's done a great job on both ends for Adam Bohodge's squad.
McGuy backing down Price. Fadeaway hook shot in the paint is just short. Booker clears. Here comes Price. Fagan left wing with it. Now up top, White gives it off to Booker. Now Price on the curl. Bounce pass over to Sweet. Backing down on Wilson, and the hook shot over Wilson is good from Jabari Sweet. Tough shot there. Barely cleared the edge of the backboard, but got it to go. 9-5, Crimson Storm. 13:23 to go first half. Mowat cut off on the drive by Fagan. Gives it back to EIA, who's back in for Bryant. Down low to Wilson. He's got Fagan on him. Out to EIA. Open three is on the way. It's short. And Dixon nearly got the tip in off the offensive glass. But it, too, rims out. SNU 4-for-10 to start this one. The Weevils just 2-of-7. Fagan into the paint, hounded by Mowat, and he's unfortunately run into from behind by Dixon. First on Dixon.
Team foul number one. Josh Denton.
Josh Denton into the game for the Weevils. Jesse White will take a seat. Price triggering it in. Gets it down low to Booker, who spun away from EIA. Missed the shot, though. Got it back in a crowd. Forced it up, and he's going to the line for two. Fouls on EIA. That'll be his first, team second. And Wesley Booker at the line for two free throws. 85% at the line this season on 60 attempts. First one's up and good. 9.6 rebounds on Thursday over in Shawnee. 5 points, 13 rebounds in the first matchup between these two. Freshman out of Mount Vernon, Arkansas. Bricks the second free throw. Wilson up high to snatch it down. Mowat to Wilson on the left elbow. Gives it to McGuy. McGuy hounded by Price. Gives it to EIA. EIA diving all the way in. He's going to be fouled as the initial shot didn't quite fall. They're going to get Booker with the foul. His first, team second. So Adokie EIA at the line for free throws. EIA been a constant presence at the line of late, but misses the first one. Davis and Bryant back in for McGuy and Dixon. Second one from Doak is good. And the lead is 10-6 as EIA cracks the scoring column. Price to Denton on the left side. Now Booker swings it over to Fagan on the right wing. Price working on the freshman Mowat. Backs him down, runs right into Davis, and a travel is going to be the call. Chad Tapp looking for a foul call there, but Price just spun and Davis was just standing there.
It's kind of how Manny Dixon got his first foul. It kind of just ran into one of the Weevil players.
Bryant, top of the foul circle to Wilson. He's got Booker on him. Crowded paint right now for SNU. They send it out to Mowat. Mowat over to EIA, behind the screen from Wilson. EIA finds himself open, three-pointer just a hair short. They keep it at 10-6. 11:35 to play, first half. Denton on the left side, over to Price. Right side, Booker. Around the perimeter they go, back to Price. Gets Mowat in the air, out to Fagan. He's got a left-wing three that's online. It's short, though, and Davis snatches down the rebound. Adam Bohatch has been harping on the rebounding of late for his squad. And entry pass down low to Davis. Reverse side, just missed it. Didn't quite get enough on the backboard there. Booker over to Fagan on the left side. So you're doing a solid job in the rebounding category thus far. 7 apiece. Not a lot of rebounds to go around in Monticello games this season. Price goes in. He's tripped and fouled. Price is down and helped to his feet on the baseline. That'll take us to our second timeout. 10:48 to play first half. SNU leading a low-scoring affair, 10-6 over the Weevils. We'll be back after these messages. This is SNU basketball.
Wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best air high five.
Back to action here at the Sawyer Center. Richard Fagan stops at the foul line, gives it over to Cole Anderson, who's back in, and he goes off glass with the left hand over Davis for two, and it's 10-8. Nearly halfway through the first half in Bethany. Tyler McGuy and Manny Dixon at the scores table, set to check back in. Next dead ball. EIA spins around Price. Goes in with a left hand. What a quick move there from EIA. I think Price thought he wrapped him up with that left arm, but man, that was quick from Doak. His first field goal. He's got three. Price down low to Booker on the cut, and a foul coming up on SNU's Nick Davis. A little bit in the body there of Wesley Booker. So Booker back at the line for two more free throws. He already has four rebounds this afternoon. One for two at the charity stripe. Booker's first up and true. Mowat and Wilson will take a break for SNU. You know Jalen Lynn today for SNU. Second one from Booker is off the back iron, no good. So SNU leads 12-9. Low scoring games in the theme for the Weevils. First one between these two teams was 53-45. Dixon pump fakes on the corner three, pivots out. McGuy run off the line, now EIA. Bryant drives baseline with two on the clock. Dixon going to have to get it up. He does in time. It's off the front of the iron. No good. And Anderson controls it. 9:20 to go first half. SNU 5 of 13 from the field, 1 of 5 from deep. The Weevils 3 of 10 from the field. Denton hands to Fagan. Waits for traffic to clear. Crosses over. Drives on Bryant. Blocked by Davis. Out of bounds. Second block of the afternoon already for Nick Davis with 9 minutes to go in the first half.
Jesse White for Wesley Booker.
White checks in for Booker. Weevils are just 9 available this afternoon. Fagan did not get the three-pointer off in time. Chad Tapp. Not pleased with his bunch. That's the second shot clock violation of the first half. Davis will check out. Mo Wilson back in for SNU.
Seems that both teams are really being tenacious on the defensive end. That's two shot clock violations in a row. Well, the Storm's almost shot clock violation.
Bryant, nice pocket pass down to Wilson. Missed the layup. Missed the left-hand tip. On the putback as well. Man, those are tough. And then Wilson gets the poke away, but Fagan gets it back, goes all the way in. Wilson with a block. Here comes Bryant down the right side to the foul circle. In the corner, Dixon over to McGuy. They swing it around. Back to Bryant. Bryant out in the corner to Dixon. He'll drive baseline all the way up. Too strong with that one. EIA. Secures it to McGuy, top of the key. Yes, sir, for three. second three-pointer of the half for McGuy. He's got eight, and SNU's up by six. Fagan holds right wing. Swing it back to Denton on the left wing. Back to Price. Dixon on him. Dixon to the cutting, or Price to the cutting. White left the right-hand hook short, but it crawls over the iron just enough to fall through for two. White's first bucket of the game. 15-11, 7:30 to play first half. Bryant will drive left. Kicks it out to Dixon. Dixon cut off by Denton. Hands to EIA. Now left side Bryant into the paint. Floater over Fagan. Off the back iron, no good. Denton has the miss. Price. White gives it up to Fagan on the left side. Now in the corner, White has it. Guarded by EIA. Price now behind the screen from Anderson. Sends it back to Fagan. Wide open top of the key for three. Barely grazed the front of the iron. And EIA controls it. He'll jog up for SNU. 15-11, 6:40 to go first half. EIA forcing the issue into the paint. Outside to McGuy. McGuy behind the EIA pick. Now EIA has it. Over to McGuy right wing. Head fake. Gives it up to Dixon. Back to Wilson, who gives it to the curling Dixon. Six on the clock for Bryant. Bryant, a head fake. Spins back the other way. Missed the jumper short. Good move there from X to get free for the shot. Just left it short. SNU now 6 of 19 from the field. Fagan can't get it into Anderson. Denton has it now. It's up top. 6 minutes to go first half. 15-11 our score. Fagan calling for the screen. Has it. Cut off at the elbow. Now White poked away by Bryant. Two on the clock. White can't get it off in time. That's another shot clock violation. Three in the first half for the Crimson Storm defense. That'll take us to our under eight timeout. 5:47 to go first half. 15-11 SNU. It's a low scoring one here in Bethany. And the Crimson Storm lead. We'll be back with more after this.
Introducing Domino's new 2-minute guarantee. Order Domino's car side delivery. Check in when you arrive, and we'll be headed out the door less than 2 minutes after it's ready, or your next pizza is free. Nothing will stop us from getting out the door fast. Rain, snow, wind.
Whoa.
And wild animals? Carry out 3-topping pizzas for $7.99 and put our 2-minute guarantee to the test.
Three shot clock violations forced by the Southern Nazarene defense here in the first half. They lead 15-11, 5:40 to go in the opening 20 minutes. Foul coming up down low on Monticello. It's going to go on Jabari Sweet.
Fouls on Jabari Sweet.
Trying to deal with Nick Davis inside. Both of them back into the contest as Anderson takes a seat for the Weevils. And your pass comes to McGuy, hounded by Price at the left elbow. McGuy into the paint, fading, off the back iron, no good. And Wesley Booker with the rebound. In the corner, Price with it for Monticello. Now Sweet. White has it. Now a hold's going to be called on Manny Dixon. That'll be his second personal foul. So he was trailing Price over a screen. So Wilson will check in for Manny. 5:11 to go first half, 20 on the clock here. Sweet as it knocked out of his hands by Davis. Do it again. Price fires it all the way up to White. Entry pass to Sweet. Kick side to Fagan for the left wing three. Nearly wedged it between the backboard and the rim on the left side. Mowat will bring it up for SNU. 15-11, 4:50 to go first half. Low scoring affair, neither team shooting particularly well. SNU at 30%. The Weevils 4-15. EIA's jumper is short. Price has it, and then a bump and a foul coming up on Wilson will be found number 6 on SNU in the first half. First on Wilson.
You just mentioned the low scoring affair, Luke. Would you credit to the great defense that's been put on display by both teams or the offensive chills on both ends?
It's been a little bit of both thus far. Sweet into Davis, forced it up, threw it too hard off the glass. Wilson tracks down the rebound for SNU. He'll jog across half court with it. Set things up. He's doubled, looking for help. Can't get it down to Davis in the corner. Mowat, rise and fire for three. It's long. Right on line. Price has it. Fagan has it left wing. There's two very deliberate teams here this afternoon. 3:50 to play first half. Still 15-11. We've been stuck on this one for a while. Fagan is going to be fouled on the drive by Mowat. And that'll be his first. Or excuse me, that'll be his second foul. The seventh team foul on SNU. So it'll be a 1-1 for Monticello when we come back out of the timeout. 3:44 to play first half. 15-11, SNU with the lead. We'll be back with more after these messages. Welcome back to the Sawyer Center, where we've gone 4 minutes without a point either way. Monticello made it 15-11 with 7:44 to go in the first half. 4 minutes later, we're still at 15-11. Richard Fagan Jr. at the line for a 1-1, 75% at the line this season, 51 foul shots, and he knocks down the first. Second one on the way from Fagan is good. So it's a 2-point game, 15-13. SNU one of their last 10 from the field, shooting 27%. Monticello, 25% here in the first half. EIA catches it flying around the corner. Sends it back up top to McGuy. Behind the Wilson pick, he'll hand to Bryant, 10 on the clock. Bryant, going to be called. They're going to get Fagan for the bump. That'll be his first. Just the fourth foul on the Weevils here in the first half. His first personal foul. Team foul number 4. Bryant will trigger it in. Fresh 20 on the clock for SNU. Gets it into McGuy. Bounce pass over to Davis. Goes up in a crowd and lost the basketball out of bounds. He got clobbered in the middle of the paint by a number of bodies and arms. Apparently nobody touched it. So the ball over to the Weevils.
We can take a couple of missed fouls here and there, but that one was deliberate. Can't miss those as a ref.
Price left wing over to Fagan, back to White on the right side. Booker sizing up Wilson, and a foul going the other way on Monticello. It's going on White with a clear out. That'll be White's first and the fifth team foul. Jackson Rothwell will check in for Mo Wilson. Rothwell started, this is his 10th appearance of the season. He started the game against Harding here back on February 7th. SNU without several players in that one. Bryant drives all the way in, hangs, and hits off the glass. And that snaps the 5-minute scoreless drought, making it 17-13, 2:35 to go first half. Left side to White. Davis and Anderson duking it out inside for position. Booker has it up top. Over to Price. Price behind the screen. Gets around Bryant. He's bumped and fouled by Bryant. Tough call there on X, and that'll be a 1-1 here for Ray Price. First on Bryant this afternoon, eighth team foul on SNU. Price 79% at the line this season. Second on the team with 75 foul shots. His first is off, and EIA clears it up for SNU. 2 minutes to play, first half, 17-13. Bryant hesitates, spins into the paint, leaves it off for Davis. He bodies his way in, and he goes up and is fouled. Nick Davis forcing the issue inside. They're going to get Cole Anderson with the foul. That'll be number two on Anderson. So Nick Davis at the line for two free throws. Davis hovering around 50% at the line this season on 47 foul shots. His first is short. I have one more. Ian Mowat checks back in for Rothwell. One more here for Davis, looking to extend the lead to five. SNU's led by as many as six, but neither team able to get any semblance of flow offensively thus far. Davis crawls that one over the rim. Anderson will check out. Jabari Sweet back in for the Weevils. Price down low to Sweet. Sweet backing down Davis. Spins away with a left and got away with a blatant travel there. SNU bench furious with that. 3-point game, 18-15. Bryant. That one goes out of bounds. Look, thought it might have been deflected there. Officials say it was not. The turnover there for the Crimson Storm. Sweet. Right side to Booker. Now over to Price now in front of Adam Bohotch on the left wing. Booker gives it up to White. Down low to Sweet. Davis tips it, saves it. And a steal for Nick Davis. Great hustle there by the big fella. Bryant in the corner, EIA. And a timeout called by EIA. 56 seconds to play in the first half. We'll keep it here. 18-15 SNU with the lead. And a struggle fest offensively. Monticello 29% from the field, SNU 30% from the field. Four of seven at the foul line for Monticello, two of four for SNU. Just neither team able to find any sort of flow offensively. Just a little bit sluggish both ways. And you heard Adam Bohan on Monday night, just felt they ran out of juice a little bit at Oklahoma Baptist. And it's been three consecutive weeks for SNU with the Monday, Thursday, Saturday schedule. And really, you take it back even further. It's five straight with an early week game. And then Thursday, Saturday. Bryant penetrating. Kick corner, Mowat up top to McGuy. 12 on the shot clock. EIA turning the corner. Bangs into Price. Now Mowat with it. Right side, McGuy gets a shot fake. Hits Price on him. Three on the clock. Looking down low. Tipped away by Sweet and stolen. Six-second difference game to shot clock. Chad Tapp's going to use a timeout to draw something up for this final possession. So again, five straight weeks for SNU on the Monday, Thursday, Saturday schedule. The first one was a Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday schedule, as that was the start of the marathon road trip in Arkansas. So it's been tough sledding for SNU as far as just the with the makeups and everything in between. So you better believe that not seeing a game early next week is going to come as a huge relief for this Crimson Storm squad. Andrew Hudeberg and Adam Bohodge each working an official in this timeout. Hey, when one guy can work an official, two is better. I'm not sure if I've really seen that with both of them working an official through the whole timeout.
Well, from our viewpoint, we really can't see much of the missed calls, like where they're actually happening, but there's been some missed travel calls and some hacks here and there, so I'm sure that they are bringing that to their attention.
Fagan just holding. 10 on the shot clock now as Monticello goes to work. White to Price. Price looking for help. Gives it over to Booker. Down low to Sweet. Two on the clock. One. Sweet fading away. Oh, and he rattled it in. 2-1. Bryant, three-quarter court at the buzzer is no good. And it's a one-point game going into halftime. Very low-scoring affair here in Bethany. 18-17, our halftime score at the Sawyer Center. We'll take an extended break and come back with first half stats, scores from around the conference, and get you ready for the second half of action. Again, our score at halftime, 18-17, SNU with the lead over Arkansas Monticello. We'll be back with more right after these messages.
Friends, family, alumni, and supporters of Southern Nazarene University, we come to you today as representatives from the Student Athletic Advisory Committee.
We're a student leadership group on campus with representatives from each of our NCAA sports. As SAC members, we are the elected voices of our teams to our administration.
We are coming to you to ask for your help for a special project.
By the end of this year, SNU will have had over 200 student athletes graduate within the past 4 years.
Receiving a degree while balancing the demands of being a student athlete means working diligently to be successful as a student and representative for our school and the kingdom.
This year, as a student group, we decided to ask our department to assist us in creating a fundraising campaign that would generate enough money
so that each student athlete who will graduate this May and next year could receive a stole to commemorate their time at SNU playing for the Crimson Storm.
We want to say thank you to our graduating seniors who have represented our university well on and off our respective stages and throughout the community.
Thank you for your support.
Thank you.
Thank you for supporting SNU Athletics.
Thank you for supporting your Crimson Storm.
Thank you. Thank you for all your support.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. Halftime score in Bethany. And, yes, this is a halftime score, 18-17. The Crimson Storm leading Arkansas-Monticello. Offense tough to come by for both teams in the first 20 minutes. In Bethany, SNU looking to snap a two-game losing streak. Arkansas-Monticello looking to snap a three-game losing streak. Both teams really locked in defensively. A lot of tough shots being put up by both schools here in the first half. SNU 30.4% in the first half, 2 of 7 from deep, 2 of 4 at the foul line. Arkansas-Monticello 33% in the first half. They were 1 of 6 from 3-point range and 4 of 7 at the foul line in the first 20 minutes. SNU, 5 more shots in the first half thanks to 7 forced turnovers by the Crimson Storm. 3 of those shot clock violations in the first half. SNU, 4 points off those turnovers, 2 for Monticello. SNU, 3 second chance points in the first half as well off 3 offensive rebounds. SNU down 1 in the rebounding category, 16-15. That is something that SNU coach Adam Bohotch has harped on the past few games, just being a little bit more aggressive on the backboards. But so far, SNU holding their own there with a Weevils team that doesn't allow a lot of rebounds, just 28.5 rebounds for opponents for Arkansas-Monticello this season. Individually for SNU, just 4 players in the scoring column. 8 points for Tyler McGuy on 3-of-6 shooting, a couple of three-pointers. Dokia EIA, 3 points, 5 rebounds. Nick Davis, 5 points, 2 blocks in the first half. And Xavier Bryant with 2 points in the first half. No points for Mandy Dixon, Mo Wilson, Ian Mowat, or Jackson Rothwell in the first 20 minutes. No Jalen Lynn for the Crimson Storm today. He's in street clothes once more. And hopefully the time off for him will get him ready for the stretch run next week. For Monticello, Jabari Sweet with 6 points off the bench. He averages 4.5 per game this season. 5 points for Richard Fagan and 2 points each for Jesse White, Wesley Booker, and Cole Anderson for the Weevils in the first half. So again, offense, a struggle here in the first 20 minutes. Looking at scores from across the conference, Henderson State on the these are women's scores. Henderson State knocked off East Central today, 63-57. The final score there. So Henderson State and East Central tied in the standings. Arkansas Tech gets outscored 55-25 in the second half by Southwestern. The Bulldogs led by 1 at halftime. They win this one today by 31, 90-59. So Arkansas Tech slips into the 7th spot. Southeastern falls to Ouachita today, 59-53. So the Tigers sweep the Savage Storm. The Savage Storm in some trouble as far as the conference standings go. Just a quick looky-loo at the conference standings on the women's side coming into today. So the loss moves Southeastern to 8-12. Oklahoma Baptist won today, so they are 10-10. Arkansas Tech lost, so they are 10-10. So Southeastern 2 games back with a couple to go down the stretch next week. Northwestern knocked off Harding today up in Alva, 65-63. So with SNU's win today and Harding's loss today, SNU now alone in second place in the conference standings with 2 games to play. And, of course, the 2 seed means that you play Thursday in the conference tournament. So first and second seeds on the men's and women's side play on Thursday evening, get Friday off before playing Saturday and ideally Sunday. So right now SNU in second. Northwestern is the next opponent for the Crimson Storm. We'll be up in Alva on Thursday night for that one. Men's side, first half score. or halftime score rather. No offensive troubles down in Weatherford for Southwestern. They lead Arkansas Tech 49-33. 11 first half three-pointers for the Bulldogs. They'll be here next Saturday. First half score in Ada, 26-16. Henderson State with the lead with 6.5 to go in the first half. Ouachita leads Southeastern at half, 33-29. The Tigers limit the Savage Storm to 34% shooting, 4 of 19 from 3 in the opening frame. Of course, the Savage Storm have fallen behind by at halftime in many games this season and have just exploded in the second half, so we'll keep an eye on that one. Over in Shawnee, Southern Arkansas with a 2-point lead over Oklahoma Baptist, 12-31 to play in the first half, and 3:30 to play first half. Harding leading Northwestern 35-30, and that would be a bit of an upset as well. Harding got the win over Southwestern on Thursday as well and are playing really well right now. They knocked off Oklahoma Baptist last Saturday afternoon also. So taking a quick look on the women's standings with today's action done, Southwestern has clinched the number one seed. SNU 2 right now at 14-6. Harding a game behind at 13-7. Still officially, I'm not sure if it's official yet, but based on these standings that we have in front of us, haven't checked social media or anything, but right now only the top three seeds have clinched a berth with a week to go in the regular season. So East Central, Northwestern, Henderson State, Arkansas Tech, Oklahoma Baptist all in it. Southeastern, I would imagine, I guess, is still technically in it, along with maybe Ouachita. It's tough to tell with how many games everybody has to play. And it looks like on the women's side, Monticello and Southern Arkansas are the only ones who have makeup games. And they'll play on Monday. So only two games remaining for everyone else. So Southeastern looks like they need to win both and probably get some help from Tech and Baptist. Ouachita appears to be out of it at this point. So we've got nine teams for eight spots on the women's side. And right now SNU would be the two seed and play on Thursday. But still two games to play. We still have a half here to play this afternoon. Both teams hoping it's a little bit better than the first. 18-17, the halftime score between SNU and Arkansas-Monticello. Both starting lineups back out to start the second half. Bryant moves left for SNU, gives it up to McGuy, top of the key, left side to EIA. To Davis up top. He hands to McGuy. McGuy bumped at by Ray Price. Now EIA has it. 12 on the shot clock. SNU diving down the lane all the way in. Too strong off the glass. Dixon flies in with a left-hand tip-in. His first bucket of the afternoon. Had a couple of huge offensive rebounds and putbacks on Thursday against Southern Arkansas in the loss. He's got two. Anderson gives to Price. Price pulls up. Tried to go to Anderson, and it's stolen by Bryant. Bryant racing Fagan all the way in. Left hand layup is good from Xavier Bryant. Adam Bohotch wanted the foul on the drive, but SNU comes out with the first four of the second half and lead by five again, 22-17. Biggest lead has been six at 15-9. Booker on the right wing, up top to White. Now Fagan. Outside Booker. Down low to Anderson. Working on Davis. Left-hand hook in the paint. It dies on the back iron and bounces in. Anderson now with four. The lead back to three for SNU. McGuy has it. Now Bryant left wing. Bryant in the corner, McGuy fakes the pass to Davis, looking for help, finds it in Bryant. Bryant with an open lane, gets around Booker, throws it up, missed it, but a foul. coming up on the Weevils. Going on Anderson, that'll be number three on Cole Anderson. So Xavier Bryant to the line for free throws. He's got 4 points this afternoon, 2 rebounds, an assist, and a steal, and he's going to the line for the first time today. 74% for Xavier Bryant at the line this season. First one on the way, rattles in.
Yeah, we might see more drives and free throw attempts for the Storm because Ray Price for the Weevils is all over McGuy, so the downtown shots might not be in favor for the Storm this second half.
Bryant's second also rattles around and in. So 2 for 2 there for Bryant. SNU now 4 of 6 at the charity stripe this afternoon. Fagan over to Booker. Up top to White. Left side to Price. Trying to get it down low to Sweet, who came in for Anderson. Booker all the way in. Leaves it for Sweet in the middle of the paint. Dixon reached in on the help side and knocked it away. Here he comes. 1-on-5. He'll wait for the cavalry to arrive. Bryant drives all the way in. Free lane. Oh, missed the layup. Davis couldn't handle the offensive rebound, and Price has it. Up top now, Booker right side to Price. Man, that was a great drive by X. Couple of those just haven't fallen for him here early in the second half. But you love the aggression. Fagan, entry pass to Sweet. Turnaround off glass, too strong from the right side. Here comes Bryant up ahead to EIA. EIA taking Fagan straight down into the paint. Outside Dixon, shot fake. He'll drive all the way in. Plays it in for two. He wanted the foul call, didn't get it. But SNU up by 7 is their biggest lead of the afternoon as the Crimson Storm start the half 8-2. Fagan gets Bryant in the air, drives, and he knocked it away from behind, saves it to EIA. Booker knocked it out of his hands, out of bounds. Xavier Bryant forcing the tempo here in the second half. He'll take a quick breather as Ian Mowat comes in for him. But Bryant with a couple big drives to the bucket, just couldn't get the shots to fall. 2 free throws and then the steal right there. His second of the afternoon. Davis at the top of the foul circle, hands to EIA. He turns the corner, flying into the paint. Shut off aggressively by White. Now Dixon, he'll drive in. Cut off by Denton. Lobs it out to McGuy. He's got it. 15-footer on the way is good from Tyler McGuy. And SNU leads by 9. 4 minutes into the second half. Great start to the second period for SNU. Price, bounce pass over to Sweet. Rejected! Official has a quick word with Davis on the action afterward, but Nick Davis with his 3rd rejection of the afternoon, and the Crimson Storm with a 9-point lead as we go under 16. We'll be back with more after these messages. This is SNU Basketball.
Wonder where the capital A and Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best air high five.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. SNU starts the half on a 10-2 run An emphatic rejection by Nick Davis right before the timeout. 15:52 to play. 28-19, SNU with the lead. Exactly what the doctor ordered for the Crimson Storm. Entry pass is wide of Jabari Sweet. It's loose, and Magai comes up with it. Secures it and gives it back to Moat. Moat over to Dixon on the right wing. He'll drive on Fagan. High off the glass and good! Manny Dixon, aggressive here in the second half. He's got six in the half. And SNU extends the lead to double figures, 30-19. Price holding up top. Sends Fagan down into the corner. Now White has it right side. Sweet. Posting up on Davis. Backing. Left-hand hook over Davis. Rolls around and off. No good. And the guy has it.
Seems like the Storm are starting to catch a little bit of a break here. Just having their shots fall and the Weevils not.
Moat penetrates but brings it all the way back out. In the corner, Manny Dixon. Back to Moat. Moat. Cross-court skip pass to EIA. EIA probing. Hesitates. Left-hand layup's no good. Davis tips it over the rim. No good. And White has the rebound. Price will bring it up for the Weevils. Weevils without Josh Williams today, their second leading scorer. Did not make the trip this weekend. Did not play on Thursday as well. White drives on Magai. Stops. Forces up the difficult shot. Missed it. Got his own rebound. And somehow put it back up and in. EIA right side. Now Magai fills in, throws it down low to Davis, who got free of Sweet and lays it in.
He kind of was a little hesitant if he wanted to do a post or dunk or not, but.
Okay, I caught in that awkward jumping position. Moat boots that one. And a fresh 20 here for the Weevils with 13:44 to play. Davis will check out along with Manny Dixon. Wesley Booker back in with Cole Anderson for the Weevils as Sweet and Fagan take a seat. Price has it, left wing, penetrates, kick out. White, three-pointer on the way, it's short. And Wilson with a nice box out and a good rebound for the Crimson Storm. One and done for Monticello. And then Price knocks it away, but a foul coming up on Price. They swiped that away from Wilson.
Yeah, Price has been extra aggressive on the defensive end, especially on Magai, not letting him get into his three-point shooting form, forcing Magai to take some quick hitters.
SNU just 7 three-point attempts this evening. Magai's got both of the makes in three shots. EIA wrapped up by White. Wow, that was really blatant and late whistle for the contact, but the lateness of it allowed it to be a shooting foul. The initial wrap-up would not have been a shooting foul. So Adokie EIA back at the line for the second time today. Just one of seven from the field today for Doak, but he does have a team-high 5 rebounds. And he's short on the first free throw. Fagan will check in for Jesse White. Second one for EIA, on the way and good. So SNU leads by 12, 33-21. to start this half for SNU. Anderson had it poked away, but Fagan has it. Now Bryant knocks it away from Fagan, finds Anderson inside, too strong with the shot. Rebound tipped by Wilson over to Bryant. Bryant up ahead to EIA, goes all the way in, lays it up, left it short. SNU wanted a foul. He got hit in the face, no call. Booker on the trailing three, top of the key, rattles out, no good. Magai knocks the rebound. No. They say it's SNU ball. Chad Tapp wanting some help from the other officials.
lot of unfortunate, odd calls going on in this sequence.
Yeah, both fairly blatant misses. EIA got whacked in the face, no call. And then on this end, pretty clear that McGuy hit that out of bounds.
We will not question it.
Again, just saying what happened, what should have happened, but no complaints given. EIA working on Booker, back up top to Bryant. 12 on the clock for Bryant. Over to McGuy. Price closes out nicely. McGuy with 5 on the clock. Rips through, spins, fades, hits! So smooth and controlled from Tyler McGuy. 14-point lead for SNU, 35-21. Anderson on the block, backing down Wilson. Mowat swiping at it. Anderson throws in the hook shot over Wilson. Just the third field goal of the half for the Weevils. It's 35-23. SNU 7 of 11 from the field here in the second 20 minutes. 11:45 to play. Bryant driving all the way around Fagan. Missed the shot, but he draws the foul on Fagan. That'll be his second, and it'll take us to our under 12 timeout. 11:38 to play here in Bethany. 35-23, SNU with the 12-point lead. We'll be back with more after this. This is SNU basketball.
Sell online tickets directly from your school's website. Scan digital or printed tickets with the Hometown Gate app. And get immediate access to ticket revenue with real-time reporting. At no cost to your school. It's that easy to bring touchless ticketing to your hometown. Hometown. Fast scans, happy fans.
Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. SNU leading Arkansas-Monticello, 35-23. Really a tale of two halves thus far offensively for SNU. Crimson Storm shot 30% in the first half. They're 7 of 11 here in the second. And Xavier Bryant at the line for two free throws, and he equals SNU's first half total with that free throw. SNU now up to 18 points in the second half.
I think we can all agree that whatever Coach Bohatch and his staff said in the locker room kind of lit a fire.
Bryant misses the second one long. So SNU now 6 of 10 at the foul line this afternoon. Booker over to Fagan on the left side. Trying to look inside to Anderson. It's not there. Price will penetrate, and he gets by everyone. Wilson denies him at the rim. Outside Denton. He'll try a three off the offensive rebound. He missed it short. And Bryant with the rebound. Wilson. Pass deflected by Booker. And here he comes behind the back. Bryant pestering. And Booker is tripped up by EIA. That's an unfortunate break for SNU. Booker was stumbling around for a loose ball there. I mean, the second on EIA. First team foul of the half for SNU, though.
Second personal foul, first team foul.
Fagan up top. Behind the screen from Anderson. Gives it back to Price. Price spinning. Good defense there by Dixon. Fagan pulls up from the foul line. That's short. Dixon has the rebound. The third for Manny today, along with 6 points all in the second half. Bryant behind the Davis pick, pocket pass to him. He fumbled it, still loose, and he finally just swats it back out to Wilson at half court. Heady play there by Davis to just swat it out of there. Six on the clock for EIA. EIA looking for help. Dixon's got it, dribbled it off his foot. EIA double clutches, three-pointer on the way. It's an air ball. So a turnover there for SNU. Just their fourth of the afternoon. But a bit of a discombobulated possession all the way around.
Yeah, multiple shot clock violations on both teams. Defense is pretty heated here in the second half.
Anderson spins, left-hand hook, throws that one in, got it in the foul. As Nick Davis got him on the arm as he followed through. So Nick will check out. McGuy back in. EIA out as well for Mowat.
Foul on Nick Davis. Second personal foul. Cole Anderson at the line.
Anderson extends and rolls in the free throw. White will check in for Denton. 10-point lead for SNU, 36-26. Weevils rattled off 5-1 over the last couple of moments. Wilson has it top of the key for SNU. Outside, Ian Mowat, his three-pointer off to the right the whole way. Booker snatches down the rebound. Price over to White, left side. Down low to Anderson. Quick left-hand shot over Wilson is good from Cole Anderson. Anderson now with eight. That's a team high. And it's 36-28. McGuy has it up top. Behind the screen from Wilson. Price right in his hip pocket. McGuy all the way in. And a foul coming up. It's going to be on Price. That'll be his second. And the fifth team foul on the Weevils. 9:08 to play.
Team foul number five.
Chad Tapp not pleased that that is a shooting foul. McGuy's first free throw on the way and good. McGuy 80% at the line this season. Wilson will check out. Davis back in. McGuy 41 foul shots this season. Bryant will check out. EIA back in for SNU. McGuy's second rattles in. 38-28. SNU with the 10-point lead. They've led by as many as 14 here in the second half. Fagan on the right side. White hesitates, loses the dribble, gets it back to Price. Price crosses over, steps inside for a long two, and rolls it around and in. First field goal made for Ray Price today. Quick timeout for Chad Tapp, and that'll take us to a timeout as well. 8:48 to play. 38-30, SNU with the lead. We'll take a break and be back with more. This is SNU basketball. Welcome back to the Sawyer Center. SNU leading 38-30. 8:48 to play in the ball game. SNU looking to snap a two-game losing streak and run their winning streak against Arkansas-Monticello to 4 overall and 8 straight in Bethany. They lost the first game between these two schools that happened in Bethany, but they've won the next 7. They lead the overall series 14-4. Monticello, a completely new team this year. They lost head coach Kyle Tolan off a Great American Conference Tournament championship a year ago to UT Permian Basin. Entire roster new for head coach Chad Tapp. McGuy takes White to the baseline. 10 on the clock. McGuy backing, spins, backing, fake spins. Still looking for help. Sends it out to Moat. 4 on the clock. Moat in the corner. Dixon, 3. In and out, no good. Not sure how that didn't stay down. The physics of that. Tough to comprehend. 38-30, 8 minutes to play. Price has it. Now left wing to Fagan. Anderson and Davis still battling inside. Fagan trying to get it to him. It's not there. Now in the corner to Booker. Anderson pulls up. Missed the shot. Davis in there for the rebound. Dixon has it. Now to McGuy. Outside Moat. To the corner in EIA. It's not there. Moat bounce pass into Davis, and Anderson takes him to the ground. No call. Now Moat has it with 5 on the clock. Over to McGuy. McGuy with 2, with 1. Got Price in the air, forced it up. He got hit on the arm. No call. And that'll take us to a media timeout. 7:18 to play. 38-30. The score here in Bethany. Well, dubious calls or no calls there. There'll be a timeout nonetheless. We'll be back with more after these messages.
Boba's new Chicken Diablo Nachos are made with hand-diced pico de gallo, which means they're as fresh as... They're also loaded with juicy adobo chicken, flame-grilled in-house, so they're as flavorful as... And they're topped off with fiery queso Diablo, so they're as spicy as... New Chicken Diablo Nachos. Try them today, only at Qdoba. United by flavor.
Welcome back. 7:18 to play. 38-30. Southern Nazarene with the lead over Arkansas-Monticello. Low-scoring affair here in Bethany this afternoon. SNU's led by as many as 14 here in the second half at 35-21. And here come the Weevils. SNU 54% in the second half. The Weevils 35%. And 34% for the game. Price has it up top. Steps inside. Hesitates. Drive pass. Dixon blocked from behind by Manny out of bounds with 10 on the shot clock. Bryant back in. Ian Moat. We'll take a seat. Price looking to trigger it in. Lobs it up top to Fagan. Price has it in the corner. Bounces in, creates some space, stops, goes up, and left it short. Davis strong with the rebound there. His third of the afternoon. 6:45 to play. Bryant between the legs working against Fagan. Up top to Dixon. McGuy comes out to retrieve on the left wing. 12 on the clock. They double McGuy. Looks for help. Finds Bryant. Bryant into the paint. Spinning. Hesitates. Forces it up. Around Fagan, and it goes. Big shot there for Bryant. He's got 9 this afternoon, and the lead back to 10. Fagan fires it in low to Anderson. Quick shot with the left hand is good. And Cole Anderson now at 13 points. Under 6 to play. SNU leading by 8. They led by 1 at halftime. Bryant drives behind the back on Fagan. Stops, pivots, off the glass again for Xavier Bryant. Taking over here in the second half. Price out wide on the right. Now Fagan. Still looking to pound it inside to Anderson here. Now Booker has it. EIA swiping at it. Fagan, left wing for 3, is online and good from Richard Fagan. His second triple of the game. And that's the second of the game for the Weevils as well. Lead down to 7, 5 minutes to play. SNU's led by as many as 14 here in the second half. But the Weevils 14-8 since then. Davis. Hard dribble over to Dixon on the right wing. Crosses over. Creates some space on Booker. Offensive foul as he sent Booker flying down the paint. That'll be the third foul on Dixon.
You can see the Storm continue to try to be aggressive on those drives. Xavier Bryant, so crafty, patient, but Manny Dixon, aggressive, but just got the unfortunate offensive foul call.
42-35, 4:43 to play. White over to Booker, now right side to Fagan. It's Fagan who knocked down a couple triples in the second half to cut the deficit to 6 in Monticello with 1:30 to play. Fagan inside, down the lane, around, no good. Anderson there by himself to force it back up and in, and it's a 5-point game, 15 for Anderson. Dixon in the corner, gives it to Wilson. Back cut's not there. Covered up nicely. Bryant behind the Wilson pick, probing. 12 on the clock, gives it to Wilson. Wilson working on Anderson. Bodies. In the corner, EIA. Rise and fire for 3. It's no good. Dixon tips the rebound. Knocked it off Price's foot. No, they say off Dixon's knee. Out of bounds. That'll take us to our under 4 timeout. 42-37, SNU with the lead, but this is going to come down to the wire in Bethany. We'll be back with the conclusion after these messages. This is SNU basketball. Back to action with under 4 minutes to play in Bethany. 42-37, SNU looking to snap a 2-game losing skid this week and get a win over the Weevils of Arkansas-Monticello. Fagan drives baseline, shovels it into the middle of the paint to Anderson, wide open, and he puts it in. Anderson has feasted here in the second half. And the lead down to a single possession, 42-39. 21-7 run. In the corner, Dixon to answer with a three. It rattles out again.
I think we might want to check that rim after this game.
No kidding. Wow. Great look for Manny in the corner there. Price in the corner in front of his bench over to Anderson. Back out top to Fagan. Fagan out to White. It's deflected, and Dixon comes down with it, and he gets the timeout. Clutch play there by Dixon going to the floor to save the possession. They didn't have the possession arrow in their favor there. So 2:42 to play. SNU still up by three. But just 7 points since the 12-11 mark. So 10 minutes of just 7 points for SNU. They're scoreless over the last 2:40. Just 2 of 11 from deep today as well. Right now, the foul line is what's keeping SNU ahead. 8 of 12 there, and Monticello 5 of 8. Both teams with 16 made field goals this afternoon as well.
Another stat that is surprising right now, SNU is responsible for 6 blocks. Great on that effort. The Weevils have none. So Nick Davis with 3, and Mo Wilson with 2. And Manny Dixon got 1 to go in there. So the effort on that end by the Storm.
Bryant will work it up into the front court for SNU. EIA. Over to Bryant, right side now. Goes behind the Davis pick. Davis dives. Bryant shovels to Dixon. Kick out in the corner, McGuy. Working inside, Price reached in, poked it away. McGuy goes to the ground, but Price is going to be called for the trip. Monticello fans in the corner can't believe it. Neither can Chad Tapp.
Well, in our defense, there's been some calls on our end the same way.
And they're going to go to the monitor and review this. I'm not sure if they're reviewing the clock or if they're going to review, like, an intentional trip. Not sure what they could be reviewing here. Certainly nothing looked flagrant, but not sure if a grabbing trip is considered a more egregious call. It might just be a clock thing as well.
Well, the way that this game has been called this evening, anything can be in the cards for what the ref decides to call.
And it looks like they're going to... Chad Tapp's not pleased, whatever. Acts like he's going to throw the clipboard. So I think they're going to call Ray Price for an intentional foul of some kind.
Last foul was upgraded to a flagrant foul, meaning that we shoot the ball and then get the ball back.
So officially a flagrant foul is the call here on Ray Price. So that's just an upgraded, so that'll be his third. The guy hits the first free throw. So big call there with 2:17 to play. Second one from McGuy is also good. So I'm assuming that the officials saw what I suspected, and that McGuy... or Price grabbed him. Or tripped him with his feet up in the air. Something of the sort. Trying to look at the replay up here right now, but back to action. McGuy has it left wing. He's open for three, and he canned it! A 5-point possession for Tyler McGuy. And SNU back up by 8 with 2 minutes to play. And Chad Tapp wants timeout. What a clutch possession there for McGuy.
Never doubt Tyler McGuy when the clock is running down. Well, first he got the two foul shots to go, and then three-pointer fell true. I think they sent 2 to 3 guys to contest that shot. Didn't bother him at all.
So McGuy now with 19 points, 3 of 4 from three-point range this evening. And a huge 5-point possession there. Monticello back with the basketball. Price has it on the right wing. Crosses over on Dixon. Now into the paint, all the way in, and a foul coming up on Manny Dixon.
Fouls on Manny Dixon. That is his fourth personal foul. Team foul number 4.
So that's Manny's fourth. Just the fourth on the Crimson Storm here in the second half. Weevils at 6. So the next one for us in, or for the Weevils. Called that on the floor, Chad Tapp over on the Monticello sideline. One of that is a shooting foul. Entry pass for Anderson, kicked by Davis, just off his shoe top there.
Looks like Manny Dixon's the only one on the Storm side in foul trouble. Everyone else has below 3.
Price, entry pass to Fagan, knocked away. It's on the ground, and Dixon again on the ground, saving the possession with a timeout. Second time he's done that here in the last few minutes. I believe that leaves SNU with one timeout remaining. I mean, Manny Dixon has had a couple really close looks at the three-point line that have just rattled out. A couple key rebounds and a couple huge possession-saving plays here in the second half. But the 5-point play by Tyler McGuy, really the difference in this one right now. The SNU basketball on the baseline, one timeout either way. Ian Mowat and EIA are back in there for SNU. Bryant on the home run lob to Dixon. Gets it around Booker, goes in. He's hacked by Anderson. And so Manny Dixon will go to the line for 2. That's the same home run inbounds pass that they used to secure the win against Arkansas Tech. Foul on Anderson will be his 4th with 1:34 to play. That's the 7th team foul on the Weevils. So 2 shots here for Dixon. First trip to the line this afternoon. 63% this season for Manny. 56 foul attempts. First one, clambers off, no good.
Nick Davis.
Have one more. Nick Davis back in for rim protection as Mowat checks back out. Second one from Dixon is perfect. And it's a full 3 possession game, 48-39. White over to Price. Lost the basketball, and it's Dixon again with the steal. Who else making the hustle plays here in the second half? Bryant bounces it up ahead to McGuy. Bryant hacked at from behind by Price. And that'll be number 4 on Price, and it'll send Bryant to the line for a 1-1 on the 8th team foul. 1:11 to play. SNU 10 of 14 at the line today. Looking to polish this one off at the free throw line. Bryant rattles in the first.
See Manny Dixon pointing his finger in the air for Bryant. That great hustle play down on the other end to kind of milk the clock, give the Weevils a chance to foul.
Bryant goes 2 for 2. Fagan drives around and behind the back on the baseline. Outside Price, three-pointer on the way. Off the back iron, no good. Davis secures the rebound. And McGuy will work it up. Doubled in the backcourt, gives it up to Bryant. Finds EIA. EIA into the front court. He's doubled, gets it over to Dixon. Back to EIA. 42 seconds to play, 10 on the shot clock for EIA. EIA with 4. Davis spins. Pump fakes on Anderson. Goes. Scoop. Missed the shot. Got it back. Put it back up. And in.
Davis.
And that, the finishing touches here this afternoon. 52-39. Fagan all the way in. Threw it wildly over the rim. McGuy has it. And that's going to do it. SNU going to snap a 2-game losing skid and move to 18-8 overall, 13-7 in conference play with a 52-39 hard-fought win over Southern Net, over Arkansas-Monticello here this afternoon. SNU sweeps the Weevils and ends the run against Arkansas with just one loss against the Arkansas schools. That was Thursday against Southern Arkansas. But here this afternoon, SNU finishes it off, gets the job done. 52-39 the final score. SNU 42% from the field. They were 3 of 12 from three-point range, all three of those coming from Tyler McGuy. We'll talk to him here in just a few moments. SNU finishes 13 of 18 at the foul line as well. Great job closing out the Weevils at the charity stripe here in the second half. Arkansas Monticello shoots 36% from the field, 2 of 10 from three-point range, 5 of 8 from the foul line, just one free throw attempt in the second half for the Weevils. SNU forced 14 turnovers today, turned those into 15 points, a key statistic in today's win. 7 turnovers for SNU today. 7 points off those turnovers for the Weevils. SNU 7-5 on second chance points, with the Weevils getting the edge on offensive rebounds, 8-5. SNU 8 steals today. 3 fast break points to none for Arkansas Monticello. Individually for SNU today, Tyler McGuy, 19 points, 6-9 from the field, 3-4 from deep, 4 rebounds. We'll talk to him in a few moments. Xavier Bryant, 13 points, 4-7 from the field, 5-6 from the foul line, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 steals. Nick Davis, 9 points, 5 rebounds, 3 blocks, 4 points, 5 rebounds for Adokia EIA, 7 points for Mandy Dixon, along with a game-high 3 steals as well. Mo Wilson, no points, 5 rebounds, and Ian Mowat, no points at 18 minutes off the bench as well. Jackson Rothwell played briefly in the first half, did not score also. Individually for Arkansas Monticello, 17 points for Cole Anderson on 8 of 12 shooting, 4 rebounds for him as well. 8 points for Richard Fagan, 4 for Jesse White, 2 each for Wesley Booker and Ray Price. Price with a game-high 8 rebounds, and 6 points for Jabari Sweet to close things out. SNU shot 55% in the second half after shooting 30% in the first half. Neither team hit 45 shot attempts in this one, so a slow pace, as we talked about in pregame with Adam Bohotch. But a great win for SNU, and they head into next week looking to take the final two on the road Thursday against Northwestern, home on Saturday against Southwestern. And that's how we'll finish the regular season. So the Crimson Storm get the win today, 52-39 over Arkansas Monticello. We'll flip over to our post-game stream on the SNU Athletics YouTube channel and sign off here on Crossover Radio Sports. We'll have full coverage on the road in Alva on Thursday here on Crossover Radio Sports, so be sure to keep it tuned there all day long on Thursday. 5:30 tip time from Alva for the women, 7:30 for the guys. So we'll flip over to the postgame stream and talk to you, Tyler McGuy and Adam Bohotch, coming up next.